All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the 2021 7th Annual Indie Awards. And two things, folks. Not only we were able to get our custom white suit tailor-made by Vinny and Barney, who owns a tailor shop that I gotta mention before next week's show, and also, well, let's just say another reason why in the world we didn't continue the movie is because of the budget that we had to put into it to get all those stars in there. And apparently, according to the maestro, Michael J. White is supposed to replace me to finish the rest of the film. I thought I told you not to finish that film. You know, that's news to me. But besides that bit of shocking news, folks, I think it's time for us to go into our first award for the night, which is none other than the Indie Story of the Year, which is an award given to a story that somehow managed to get our minds off the three P's that's been plaguing us throughout this entire year: politics, protests, and of course, the most popular one of all, a pandemic. And with that said, folks, Dan the Weatherman Stu, if you will, please read the nominees for this year's Story of the Year. And here are your nominees for this year's Story of the Year. G4 Returns. What the heck is G4? Well, Dan the Weatherman Stu, G4 was a gaming network that was originally on a channel that you could only get on a satellite dish or with cable, that somehow slowly but surely evolved into a home for reruns of Cops, Chicago PD, and even for reruns of Campus PD as well, until its unfortunate death in 2012, only for it to make a resurgence 9 years later with not only old faces, but new faces as well, including none other than Up Up Down Down's own Austin Creed. And I can't wait till it makes a return in 2021. Boys led Black Widow Spider Bite 'em thinking they would get super powers! Ha ha! Like Spider-Man! Well, Dan the Weatherman Stu, you are right on that, because three young Bolivian boys would decide to actually let a Black Widow spider biting them, thinking that they would get powers like the hero Spider-Man. Only for them to, well, let's just say, end up in the hospital with a severe poison from that Black Widow spider. And if you're asking me right now, Maestro, hell no, I would not let a spider bite me thinking I would get superpowers. The only thing I would get is a trip straight to the emergency room, but hey, these kids are young. You know, now they've learned. Man dresses up as Gene Simmons of Kiss to deliver the mail! Shout it out loud! Hey, I'm surprised you know that song, Dan the Weatherman Stu, but besides that, the fact that this man in the UK who decides to deliver the mail, who goes by the name of Gary Underdown, who would decide to cheer up people during the pandemic by dressing up as Kiss, not only wearing the hair, but also the cool boots while delivering the mail, definitely is a nice touch to help people get over these pandemic times we're currently in. And according to what the maestro told me, he's still doing it to this day. Nice! The Undertaker tombstones a pumpkin or a scarecrow for a Halloween event! Rest in peace! Yeah, Dan the Weatherman Stu, apparently the Undertaker, to help out Jimmy Fallon to somehow cross over wrestling with Halloween, decided to tombstone pile drive a scarecrow before making it rest in peace. And not to mention probably one of his first appearances outside of the WWE post his retirement. Or, you know, before his retirement out of the ring. I forgot, he didn't retire until the Survivor Series, and this took place on Halloween. My bad. Rapper turns himself in after shooting a flamethrower on the top of a bus. Now that's hot. Are you copying Paris Hilton so we can get sued for that too? No? Well, besides that, folks, he's right about it being hot, because Dupree God would decide to shoot a flamethrower on the top of the bus just for the art and for the Wu-Tang, and once again bringing the Wu-Tang Clan into the Indie Awards once again for the 7th year in a row? Hard to believe, no matter how many times we tried to escape the 38 chambers, they somehow managed to get involved for the Indie Awards. It's amazing, folks. Absolutely amazing. Speedrunner sets record for Super Mario 602 star run! That's impressive! Yes, Dan the Weatherman Stu, after a 5-year-long record that stood the test of time, we would see a man that goes by the name of Oddmay, who would end up beating the record that was previously set back in 2014, only for him to go on and just beat this record in under 20 minutes. Or is it 20 hours? Either way, folks, a very impressive record that I still can't believe he was able to beat. And according to the Mike Show, it was 20 hours. Thank you for the correction. 12-year-old DJ has equipment confiscated after having a bathroom rave. Wish he invited me. And with him inviting you, how in the world that would prevent the equipment from getting stolen? I would have brought a better party to the world! You know what? I don't put it past you, but at the same time, folks, yes, a boy that goes by the name of Cal Bell, and I find it funny his name sounds like Cal Bell from the SNL skit, would be able to invite everybody to a makeshift rave in a school bathroom, and would be able to even have some form of fun in there that would last approximately 30 minutes before the anti-fun police would show up to break it up. And the funniest part about all this is, folks, is the mother would find some form of comedy behind this because of how it went down. And in my opinion, the fact that nobody got hurt, there was no immediate fire, this probably might be one of the best news stories we've heard all year coming from out of a school that doesn't lead to some form of riot. And with all the nominees read, Dan the Weatherman Stu, if you will, please read the winner for this year's Indie Story of the Year. And the winner for this year's Indie Story of the Year is... drum roll, please! 12-year-old DJ has equipment confiscated after school after a bathroom rave! Ha ha! Congratulations! Congratulations indeed, especially beating out the Wu-Tang Clan, who's been sweeping the awards every single year with the crazy news stories they have. But somebody having a rave in the bathroom? A real tough story to beat. So once again, congratulations, and hopefully you get your DJ equipment back before the end of the year. And if it's like my school, chances are you'll probably get it before the last day of school. So hopefully you get it back. And with that said, folks, we might as well head back into the music, and when we return, we'll be back with the next award of the night, which will be none other than the Screenshot of the Year, right after a word from our sponsors. So don't go anywhere just yet, folks, and stay tuned.